viewers, myself Dr. Arvind Kumar Shakya, Assistant Professor of Biochemistry at the School of Sciences, Indira Gandhi National Open University, New Delhi. Today, I will discuss about the cell. It is a building block of life. Today, I will discuss about the following learning objectives: cell and cell theory, morphology of cells, and the cellular organization of prokaryotes and eukaryotes. And we will discuss about the differences between prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cells. And the study of cell structure and function in the scientific field, we call it the cell biology. The understanding of life process is an important aspect of cells. And here you can this in this picture, there are so many cells of the plant tissue which is observed under the microscope. And we know that all living organisms are made up of one or more cells, and in this slide we shows that the prokaryotic organisms are unicellular, means they are made up of single cell, and eukaryotic organism, you can see dogs and plants, they are made up of the eukaryotic cells and they have many cells. What is cell? Cell is a structural and functional unit of life. It is the fundamental unit of life. At the structural level, the all living organisms are the same. It is the smallest unit of living things. All people, plants and animals, they are all are made up of the smaller cell. Cell is capable to grow, reproduce, perform and essential metabolic functions. Cell also respond to environmental conditions, and it respond to through the signal by the plasma membrane, and it can also adapt or it can also change itself according to environmental needs. And cell has a good metabolic machinery by which the nutrients can convert to chemical energy. The study of cell, it depends on the microscopic observation. When the invention of the microscopy, it is an instrument which magnify the smaller objects. So, the structure and function of cells is elucidated using this light microscope and electron microscope. The discovery of the cell is first biologist called Robert Hooke. He is the first man who coined the term the cell, cellula. He viewed the thin slice of cork of plant under the microscope and observed tiny compartments. This tiny compartments, he said that is the cell, which is resembled to honeycomb. And another biologist, Anton Leeuwenhoek, was a Dutch businessman, and he made optical lens that could magnify object up to 500 times, and he was the first scientist to see living cells in a drop of water, and they discovered many organisms like protozoa and red blood cells. For later on, after the study of cell by the Robert Hooke and the Anton Leeuwenhoek, another biologist, Matthew Jacob Sillidan, conclude that plant cells are made up of cells, and similar observation was obtained by Swan. He also studied the animal tissue and proposed that animals are made up of cells. And further study, the Rudolf Virchow is another scientist. He postulated that one cell is originated through another cell, means through the cell division. So, cell can replicate to another cell. So, the contribution of these all scientists led to the cell theory, which states that a cell is the structural and functional unit of life. All living organisms are made up of one more cells, and new cells arise from the division of pre-existing cells. So, how the cell is originated? What is the basic component of cell? is made up of the. This first cell is presumed in early biological evolution, that is the evolvement of the self-replicating molecule, call it ribonucleic acid RNA. The RNA molecules and other associated molecules is enclosed within the membrane, which is made up of the phospholipids. So, the formation of organic molecules or inorganic molecules, they lead to the formation of bilayer membrane, and surrounding the bilayer membrane, there is aqueous fluid which is dissolve the organic molecules, which is the ribonucleic acids. So, the come to the cellular morphology. There are various cell and shape of the cell. We have identified the morphology of the cell using the microscope, and cells are differ in various shape and size, and cells has spherical, round, elongated, spindle shape and branch. There are so many shape of the cell. The shape of the cell decide the function of the cell. So, the size of the cell is varies from the prokaryotic to eukaryotic cell. Prokaryotic cell is generally 10 to 100 micrometer, and the prokaryotic cell is 1 to 5 micrometer. Prokaryotic organism is made up of the only one cell, which is called the prokaryotic, and eukaryotic organism is made up of the more than one cell, which has the eukaryotic cell. So, in this slide we can see the many type of the cell, which has various cell shape and size. Now, we can see in the slides, there are various scale of the molecules of the cell, and the human eye can see more than 100 micrometer molecules, and less than 100 micrometer we need to the microscope to visualize the cell molecules and subcellular structures. Cell is a microscopic in size, so we need a microscope to visualize the cell, and to visualization of the subcellular organelles or subcellular structure of the cell, we need a electron microscope, which has a high resolution compared to the light microscope. Why are cells so small? Because the surface area to volume ratio limit the cell size. So, what is surface area? Surface area, if we consider the surface area, the outer surface of the layer, suppose this is the hand, and this is the surface of the skin. So, the if we consider the circular shape, so the surface area, it is the surface area means plasma membrane of the cell, because plasma membrane is covering of the cell. So, we call it the surface area, and inside the surface area there is a volume. How much volume is covered by the surface area, which is called the volume. So, surface area to volume ratio limit the cell size. If the surface area is greater than the volume, the cell size is small, and if the surface area is to volume ratio is less, then cell is very big. So, the cell is microscopic in size, and we can consider the surface area is 1 centimeter width, height and length, and it is 6 sides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So, 6 sides, we multiply the 1 centimeter, and the volume is also 1 centimeter cubic. At we calculate the surface area and volume ratio, it is 6:1. If we increase the surface area and the volume 2 centimeter in the slides, and calculate surface area to volume ratio is high, 3:1. So, we can say that the surface area volume ratio is high, the cell size is small. If the big of the surface area to volume ratio is small, then cell is big. And the importance of surface area, it means the small size means has a large surface area, which help to exchange of material surrounding, and also the cell can transport the unwanted material from the cell to environment. And when cells become larger, transport rate of material would be slow to reach center of the cell, and therefore large cells tend to divide into daughter cells and again to produce cell with higher surface area to volume ratio. This is the reason the cell divide to another cell and it goes to the cell division. This is the reason when the cell size is big, the volume is increased and cell surface is increased, then to cell and divide. So, it again the cell size is small. Now, what the how we define the cell classification? We define the cell into two major groups. One is prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell. Here pro means before or early, karyon means nucleus. Before nucleus, it means the prokaryotic cell has no membrane bound nucleus. In prokaryotic cell, the DNA genetic material is present in the cytoplasm in a form of nucleoid. And here in eukaryotic cell, it has a true nucleus. It means the membrane bound nucleus. The genetic material is bounded by the nuclear envelope. So, in eukaryotic cell has the membrane bound nucleus, the true nucleus. So, this is the basis of the classification of cell on the basis of the cellular organization. But the fundamental features of the both cell, prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell, are the same, such as both cell has DNA, ribosomes, cytoplasm and plasma membrane. The plasma membrane is covered the outer surface of the cell, which define the cell shape and cell size. And the ribosome present in both cells, prokaryotic cell, eukaryotic cell, but it has a 70S in prokaryotic cell and 80S in eukaryotic cell. And both cells are DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid, it is the DNA, and the inside the plasma membrane we call the cytoplasm. It is a aqueous fluid, jelly like fluid, which is present in the cell. Now, there are three domain of the living organism begin the phylogenetic tree. The first living organism on the earth was Archaebacteria. They are the primitive organism and which diver to prokaryotes and eukaryotes. So, eukaryotes organism are contain the eukaryotic cell and prokaryotic organism are contain prokaryotic cell. So, the both prokaryotic and eukaryotic organism are originated from the primitive polynucleated cells, which is the Archaebacteria or archaea. Now, we talk about the archaea. Archaea is the prokaryotic organism, which is the ancient one, which originated first on the earth about 3.5 billion years ago. Without nuclei and membrane bound organelles, archaea are unicellular organism and their genetic material is DNA. They divide by the binary fission, wording and fragmentation or other way. They can be spherical, rod shaped, spiral and irregular or pleomorphic, means they have no cell wall. Here in this print slide, you can see Thermoaquaticus and Methanococcus Archaebacteria. Archaebacteria are, there are many forms of Archaebacteria present on the earth. And they are extremophiles. They survive adverse condition of environmental temperature, such as halophiles survive at high salt conditions 3-4 mole NaCl. Thermophiles can survive optimum high temperature 80 degree or 85 degree centigrade. Saprophiles bacterial can survive a very low minimum temperature minus 10 to minus 20 degree centigrade. Alkalophiles survive at high pH, pH 9 to 11, and piezophiles survive at the high pressure 300 atmosphere. And acetophile Archaebacteria survive at high temperature with acidic conditions. So there are many forms of Archaebacteria which survive adverse environmental conditions. Now come to the bacteria. Bacteria is also a unicellular organism. It is a type of prokaryotic cell. It is well studied. The well studied bacteria is E. coli, Escherichia coli. The structure of bacteria is very simple. It has a cell wall which is made up of the peptidoglycan, and under the cell wall there is a cell membrane, and the inside the cell membrane of prokaryotic cell bacteria, it has a ribosome, 70S ribosome, chromosome, DNA. The DNA is present as a nucleated form because it is not bounded by the nuclear membrane, and there is a one flagellum you can see here and the pili. So the structural organization of the bacteria, such as nucleated region, it helps to replication. Ribosome responsible for photosynthesis, cell membrane provide the shape, and cell wall it protects from the outer environments. And there is a capsule is also present in outer side of the bacteria. Flagellum is helps to movement, and pili is helps to adherence of the surface. Essential bacteria, without bacteria life on earth would be different, because there are so many bacteria as present in our body which help to digestion of food. And plants also has bacteria, bacteria which is present in the root which fix the atmospheric nitrogen. So bacteria are also helpful to our food digestion. So this type of bacteria are called good bacteria. There are so many bad bacteria which cause the diseases, such as Mycobacterium tuberculosis, which are responsible for TB, tuberculosis disease. There are so many bacteria harmful. So they are called the bad bacteria. But those bacteria which are useful to human body, they are called good bacteria, because they are also help to food digestion and also provide the vitamins. Now let us discuss the eukaryotic cell. Eukaryotic cell is a complex structure which has a many compartments. Here you can see in this slide the all plants, animals, fungi, protists are considered in the eukaryotic cell. Animal and plants consist of eukaryotic cell, but they differ each other. Here you can see amoeba, euglena, cat and plants. They are all eukaryotic organism which is made up of the eukaryotic cell. The cell is made up of the many organic and inorganic molecules, and these molecules organize into subcellular organelles, and the cell converts into tissue, tissue converts to organ, organ converts to organ system, and the finally made up of the a living organism, or we can call it the human body. Human body consists of trillions of cells. There are 200 types of cells which is responsible for formation of the human body. In this slide you can see the blood cells, skin cells, bone cells, epithelial and goblet cells, cardiac cells, nerve cells and muscle cells. These cells are perform specialized function in the body, and their shape is very different. And eukaryotic cell structure, you can see here the eukaryotic cell structure, animal cell and plant cells. Both cell have different cell organelles, but they are differ with few things. Animal cells has ribosomes, endoplasmic reticulum, mitochondria, Golgi body, peroxisomes, lysosomes. Similar to these organelles are also present in the plant cell, but plant cells has the chloroplast, cell wall and vacuoles which are not present in the eukaryotic cell. So these cells are quite different, but they have similar in the terms of subcellular organelles. Bacteria, you can compare the bacteria and plant cells. Bacteria are simple organism which have no subcellular organelles. They are simple in structure. Their size is so small, 2 micrometer, but the plant cells has 100 micrometer in size, and the plant cells structure has compartmentalization, means the cytoplasm is compartmentalized, these distinct compartments. They have membrane bound organelles. These organelles are not present in the bacteria, means the prokaryotic cell. So, these are two different cellular organization between bacteria and plant cell. And in this slide, you can see the prokaryotic cell, eukaryotic cell. In prokaryotic cell, no true nucleus is found, but the DNA is found in the nucleoid form. We can say the nucleoid. And eukaryotic cells has a membrane bound nucleus, it is the true nucleus. And membrane bound organelles are absent in prokaryotic cell. Eukaryotic cell, the membrane bound organelles present, such as endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi body, peroxisomes, lysosomes, chloroplast, mitochondria are present in eukaryotic cell. The type of ribosomes, 70S present in prokaryotic cell, and eukaryotic cell has 80S ribosomes. So, this is the S is the sedimentation coefficient which define the shape, size and density of the ribosome. Cell wall present, which is made up of the peptidoglycan and cell wall is also present in plants, which is made up of the cellulose. Cell division, and the prokaryotic cell divide in the cell division by binary fission, and the eukaryotic cell divide by the mitosis in somatic cell and meiosis in germ cells. Both cells have DNA, but the eukaryotic cell DNA present in the chromosome. It is a very large structure, thread like structure in eukaryotic cell, and the prokaryotic cell has the DNA which is the circular, and no compartments present in the prokaryotic cell, but the different compartments present in the eukaryotic cells, such as cytoplasm and nucleus. And the different components is available in the plant cell, such as ordering molecules are responsible for the formation of plant cells, and the DNA is made up of the polynucleotide chain, which is the nitrogen bases. Cell wall is made up of the cellulose, and the membrane is made up of the phospholipids. So, this is the overview of the plant cell composition, which is the 4 major biomolecules responsible for the formation of the plant cell, and they also provide the energy, protein, carbohydrate, lipids, DNA and RNA. Thank you. So, I hope this session will be very useful to introduce you the cell and structure of the prokaryotic eukaryotic cell.